So get this, guys. Yeah, they get upset if I stay in their area, but if I just quickly walk past them forward to this, you know, to try and get to the manhole cover, they're okay with it. They just don't want me hanging around there for a long time. We have to shut you down. The World Order and their team of experts could be trying to trap us. So at least there's that. So it's like, it's not like they'll attack you just on sight. They're just like, hey, get out of here. Don't hang around here. Let's see. Ah, here's O'Malley. I'll talk to him in a second. Let's see if I can shut this down. No, it's still not right here. I think I gotta get an upgrade where it's like I can walk through electricity without getting hurt. Alright. So, O'Malley, let's talk.
Yes? May I help you?
Actually, I've been told by a mutual acquaintance that it might be the other way around.
Were you followed?
Huh. By a clown and a midget for a while. I'm a professional. Nervous, sorry. Here we go. I'll be like, I'm a professional.
I'm a professional. I know how things work. So if we can just skip Cloak and Dagger 101.
Well, you certainly look the part. Now let's see how well you can play it.
So what is it you need?
Straight to business. A rare quality these days. Tell me, are you familiar with local gangs?
More than enough to get by.
Perfect. Now, I warn you, this is not the cleanest of work, but your efforts will be well compensated. An associate of mine will leave a package for you in an alley on Grand River Road. You will retrieve this package and then use it to deal with a problem of mine. Permanently.
Who's the target?
Someone who won't be missed, I assure you. A ganger that goes by the name Double T.
Double T, huh?
Around in an apartment near Earl's Court. It's not likely that he'll be alone. Just as it's not likely the people keeping him company will be of the pleasant sort. You can't miss him. He's got prominent and rather tasteless augmentations to his face and arms.
You're telling me you went through all this trouble to hire me just so I can eliminate a banger?
That would be a tad overkill, I admit. No, eliminating the target with the weapon provided to you is only the first part of your assignment. Once you've dealt with Double T, I need you to sneak into Derelict Row and plant the murder weapon among the Baller's weapon stash, unnoticed.
Kill a member of the Motor City Bangers, then plant the murder weapon in the rival gang's weapon stash. You're trying to start a war.
Hopefully.
Really? He wants to start a war? Where can I find the weapon stash?
I can get inside Derelict Row, but where can I find their weapon stash?
Look for an old concrete structure that is boarded up and condemned. I believe they stock their supplies right underneath it.
Okay. And what about the location of the target?
I need a more precise location on the target.
There's a small back alley known to the locals as Earl's Court. You can access Double T's building using the fire escape. He's in one of the apartments on the fourth floor.
Fourth floor. And the package?
So what is it I'm picking up and where is it exactly?
There's a rather luxurious apartment complex on Grand River Road. In front of it, on the other side of the street, you'll see a door that leads to a maintenance corridor. In the first corner of that corridor, you will find a crossbow hidden amongst the trash and debris. Use it to kill Double T.
Okay. Now, about, you don't sound like a cop.
You don't sound like a cop.
You, on the other hand, are starting to sound exactly like one. I strongly suggest you simply get on with the program.
All right. Sounds like you're just the middleman.
I don't understand what you're getting out of this. It sounds to me like you're just the middleman for someone else.
You think too much, my friend. This could prove to be a source of great personal...
Yeah, he's definitely an alpha.
...for you in the near future.
All right, and this gang war?
So what's the plan? You make a call and rat one of the bangers out? Then the DRBs retaliate and so on and so forth until they wipe themselves out?
Pretty much.
What about innocent casualties? These thugs aren't exactly expert marksmen, and it's pretty hard to aim from the window of a moving car. What could be worth such a risk?
I won't discuss my motives with you. I hired you to do a job. Just do it.
Uh-huh. All right. Let's appease him.
You obviously want this done quick and done well. I respect that. All I'm asking for is half the payment in advance as a gesture of goodwill. In my line of work, you simply can't afford to be careless.
You've got guts, I'll give you that. You've got yourself a deal.
Nice. Got 1,000 credits up front. Very nice. Okay. Huh. Let's see if I can hack this first. Come on. Got that. Nice. And got that. Very good. More experience there. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Seraph Industries report. Incident report. Terrorist attack on Seraph Industries. Probably some unidentified high-tech compound. While examining the crime scene, Detective Hayward and I both noticed that the area covered by the attack seemed abnormally damaged, burned to a degree that cannot be explained by normal fire. Residue analyzed by forensic lab officers on the scene likely comes from a high-tech accelerant or an unknown nature. It seems the lab's equipment and victims were deliberately burned to an excessive degree. The most obvious conclusion is that this was done to eliminate all possible trace evidence, but it feels odd, like something is off. Okay. Alright. Apart from Seraph's chief of security, who is still in a critical condition in edited, and another lab technician who is lying in a deep coma in the same hospital, the only witness to the attack on Seraph was left alive, and tech named Arthur Hopkins. Something peculiar regarding the witness's deposition, or lack thereof, when we first got on the scene, Mr. Hopkins was waiting for us in a rec room near the labs. He was obviously in shock, but was quite coherent and ready to give a clear description of the incident. The emergency response team wanted to make sure his condition was stable before allowing us to interview him. When we came back after his checkup a few minutes later, he was incoherent and confused. He couldn't remember anything about the attack. We still haven't heard back from the ER team regarding this matter. Addendum. The situation has been resolved with the medical team. Mr. Hopkins' condition has been validated. He suffered from a severe concussion. This matter is closed. Quick rundown. There was no trace evidence found at what seems to be the point of entry. The incident didn't last long, but the amount of damage was excessive. There was a large number of victims, and yet not many rounds were fired, and the accuracy was spot on. The attackers were probably all marksmen. This was the work of top-notch professionals. Seraph confirms that a new augmentation design was being tested just prior to the attack, but that was that the augmentation itself was unharmed and no files related to it were stolen. The obvious motive here is theft and or corporate espionage. But why then destroy the facility and murder everyone? A competitor could no doubt benefit from such a catastrophe, but these measures were quite extreme, and to my knowledge, this is an incident without precedent. I want to note here that I brought this matter up to Lieutenant Ashbrook on multiple occasions with no concrete results. Let's see, there's one more here. Find all the evidence related concerned to Cassandra. Okay. So this is on... Ah, here it is, the autopsy report on Megan Reed. 32, blood type O positive. I have been appointed by the state to perform autopsies on the remains of multiple victims of the attack on Seraph Industries. This is due to the critical nature of the incident and the need for the State Department to be fully aware of every detail without going through an endless array of bureaucratic forms and requests. This is no way linked to the competence of local ME, Dr. Gerald Campbell, and shouldn't be interpreted as such. File diagnosis. Vertebral injuries. Vertebrae in the neck area are displaced. Abrasion of the bones consistent with severe and sudden stress on pressure. Number 2. Ligature strangulation. A. Abrasions found in the neck area. Hard to clearly verify due to severe burns, but throat seems crushed. Severe burns. Extremely severe burns covering the entirety of the body. Accelerant residue has been sent to chem lab for analysis. Absence of fumes, residue, and ash in the lungs. Indicate burns are post-mortem. Toxology report. Blood ethanol non-detected. Blood drug screen, no drugs detected. Clinical pathologic correlation. Cause of death is quick and intense snapping of the neck vertebrae combined with crushing pressure. Body was likely burned after the subject was deceased. So, if... I'll tell you what, though. That leaves the possibility that she could be open. Look. If a body is burnt, then the idea... Okay, so I have the code. But it always seems a possibility that that person could be alive because, well, you know... Oh, wait, I don't have what I need. Hold on a second. Don't I have 2 points? Yep. That could still be alive. Alright, so let's go ahead and make it where I can capture that. So I used 1 point for that. Gonna need these two. I don't need to do that right now, though. Let's increase the inventory size. There we go. Alright. You know what? Let's go ahead and make a save here before we do this. So we can try and avoid, getting the detective in trouble by using the code. Let's at least try and hack into it. We could use the auto-hack device, but I kind of want to save those. Alright, here we go. Whoops. Oh my goodness. Come on, come on, come on. Yeah, I did it. So what's in here? Megan Reed lab notes. It's hard to fathom it all sometimes. When I made that breakthrough in my research a couple years ago, I never thought it would get this big. I thought it was an anomaly at first, but it's become to genetics what universal assemblers are to nanotechnology. We're talking about the holy grail DNA here. Heck, this is Gregor Mendel big. The thing is, I have to bury the truth. Not the discovery, but how I reached my results. It's become harder lately. I betrayed someone I respected for the sake of my research. I wish I had a chance to fix it, but it got bigger than me, bigger than Seraph. If this ever came to light, Seraph Industries could be ruined. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm tired. I think I'll just wrap things up for today. That's the indication I got from Megan when we talked, all that long ago. But she just wouldn't talk about it. Who did she betray and why? A bracelet? Huh. I wonder if this belonged to Megan. I'll catch you later, O'Malley. Huh. I can use these boxes here. Try and just hop on over, rather than have to go through the sewers again. Huh. Hello, hobo. Don't mind me. Just stacking some boxes, that's all. Make a little ladder for me. Alright, so now that's in place. Now let me look one more time, see if there's a way I can shut down this electricity over here. I guess it's not this close. I thought it was like right here. Nope. It must be like in the middle. That's so stupid. There we go. Hopped on over. Okay, so let's see. Quests. Well, we've done everything we can here for this one. And we helped kind of protect that detective. So I guess the last thing to do is go to Cassandra Reed, who I guess is, she's at my apartment building. So remain undetected while in that territory. Go to Derelict Row. Retrieve the package. And then bring it back to Jenny. Locate the hideout. It says she needs the witness alive and talking. So I wonder if I, when I go there and I find him out, if I can just like knock him out. So before we do that, we'll head back to my apartment building. We'll turn in this quest to Cassandra, and then we'll go up to my apartment and see what we can do about this device. And who knows? Maybe it'll also lead me to over there. If I'm gonna be heading over there, maybe I can have to do that for the main story mission. May as well, right? Into my apartment we go. Alright, so there's a couple ways I can handle this, which involve getting a couple trophies. It's auto-saving. Hold on. Come on.
Just blown through the roof, thanks to the arrival of William Taggart, celebrity author and founder of the...
Alright. Make a manual save.
Have you found anything? Please, I've got to know what really happened to Megan.
Complete the quest.
I've investigated all of Detective Chase's leads. You were right. Something was off with Megan's case.
Yep.
So,
there is.
What did you find?
Well, a witness suddenly couldn't remember anything.
There were only three people who got out of the labs alive. Me and two others. One died in the hospital a few days later. A second one, a lab tech, was ready to give a detailed description of what he saw. Funny thing is, by the time the investigators got to him, he couldn't remember a thing.
Or more so chose not to.
You don't believe that.
I don't. Not from the reports I've read. I think someone got to him first.
Yep, I think so too. Someone ordered a specially appointed medical examiner.
Someone in the government, a man named Manderley, ordered that a specially appointed medical examiner perform the autopsy. He bypassed the local ME. Simply put, that's not a good sign.
Nope.
It sure doesn't sound good.
The identification.
I got my hand on a test report that confirms what was bothering Chase. The attackers used excessive measures to make bodies and equipment unidentifiable.
Oh my God, Megan. What do you make of this, Adam?
I don't know exactly. I guess the idea was to leave no traces, no DNA evidence that would link back to them. But it just seems a bit too convenient.
And the mercs. The footage showed fuzzy images of the attackers bringing something inside the labs.
An officer assigned to the case was asked to get rid of a major piece of evidence. Footage from one of our intellicams showed fuzzy images of the attackers bringing something inside the labs.
What? What were they bringing in?
I don't know. But for someone higher up to want that evidence gone, it must have been important.
So what you're telling me is we couldn't find anything conclusive?
No, I'm sorry. But one thing's for sure. Somebody's been hard at work covering up and destroying evidence related to this case. Somebody with power, who wanted to erase anything that might have made the investigation linger.
So I can either give her that bracelet, Megan's bracelet, or keep it for myself. I'm going to make both choices, actually. I'm going to show you guys what you can get. I'm going to keep the bracelet first.
I'm sorry, Cassandra. I wish I had more tangible answers to give you.
It's all right, Adam. I'm sure you did all you could. At least now I know my instincts were right. And, do you know exactly how Megan died?
So there's a trophy there, you see. Sentimental value. I can either be detached or empathetic. Her neck was snapped and her body was burned. Oh, gosh. She didn't suffer, Cassandra. I can promise you that. I mean, that's true. If her neck was snapped, then it was instant. And she didn't suffer because she was already dead. Yeah, I'll be empathetic.
I read the reports. She didn't suffer, Cassandra. I can promise you that.
Thank you, Adam. It's not much, but it still brings me some comfort. I miss her so much.
Not much you can do about that. Optimistic. Don't worry, Cassandra, it's not over.
Don't worry, Cassandra, this is not over. I don't know how or when, but I will get to the bottom of this.
I knew I was right to trust you, Adam. But please, be careful. It's strange. I thought knowing what really happened would make me feel better. But nothing will ever justify this. My daughter is gone, and I'll never get her back. I wish I could be sure she gets justice.
Trust me, she will.
Alright. So I think I'll get a trophy for that, for completing this quest, any second. There it is, Motherly Ties. So you can get a trophy for keeping the bracelet. Now, obviously, I don't necessarily want to do that because she kind of should have the bracelet. There's really no point to me keeping the bracelet. So I'll just reload, and this time I'll turn it in. I'll try and skip all the dialogue, and then I'll give her the bracelet. I mean, you know, there's really no point in having Adam keep it other than getting that trophy. And I think she should be the one to have it. Just odd that they kept her bracelet and didn't give it to her next of kin, her mother.
Have you found?
All right, so let me skip the dialogue here. I'm just mashing square and give the bracelet.
I'm sorry, Cassandra. I wish I had more tangible answers to give you. But I did stumble on something I think you should have. I found Megan's bracelet. I'm sure she'd want you to have it.
Oh, Adam. That's very kind of you. Her grandmother gave it to her.
Aww.
She loved that bracelet very much. Thank you for all you did. And, do you...
Alright, so now we have these same dialogue choices. Optimistic. Alright. So there we go. It's a nice little quest to help find out some more about what happened to Megan, about her mom.
Where are you, Jensen? I haven't gone all night.
Jeez, Pritchard, I'm on my way.
I'm almost in.
Going up the elevator.
Well, when you do get in there, connect the neural hub to your computer. I've created a secure tunnel, and I'll take over remotely.
Oh,
you can
great.
Access my personal computer.
Who do you think configured your security protocols?
Oh, that's just what I want, is Pritchard having access to my own personal computer.
Welcome home, Mr. Jensen.
Thank you, strange, random AI voice, who always says the same thing whenever I show up at home. Nothing new here. Alright, let's hook it up to my computer. Let's see what Pritchard can find out about this. And let's hope it doesn't ruin my own personal computer here. We won't risk the company's
Pritchard,
computer, but we'll risk yours.
Connected.
I know. Now be quiet and let me concentrate.
Fine.
I need his name, Pritchard, not his entire genetic history.
That's not his DNA. It's the data he was trying to steal from us before he... My God, Jensen. Your suicide hacker didn't kill himself.
You obviously didn't see his brain splattered all over the floor.
No, you don't understand. The wet drive modification in this chip, it allows someone to hack through you. It turns you quite literally into a human proxy.
So someone...
So he wasn't working alone. Someone off-site was doing the actual hacking.
And then
exactly.
Must have killed him.
And whoever it was tried to hide his location by using multiple satellites.
Whoa.
But I may have just traced him to here. An abandoned factory complex in Highland Park.
Get me the address, Pritchard. Because if we're lucky, whoever pulled our terrorist strings might still be there.
Huh.
Adam? It's David.
Let me guess. You're sending me to Highland Park.
Not just yet.
What?
Frank's figured out why the network's been compromised. There's a persistent transmission coming from Derelict Row.
Derelict Row, what a convenience.
Well, our dead friend was posing as an Antiog. Who better to hide with than the D-Row ballers?
Right. I'm on my way.
On my way.
Re-establishing security system.
Thank you.
See you soon, Mr. Jensen.
See you soon, apartment voice. See? I told you it was probably gonna have the main mission be in Derelict Row. Now imagine if we had done that and gone through Derelict Row and all that. And then all of a sudden the game goes, hey, guess what? You gotta go back. Yeah.
Hello? Well, I can see where they're coming from.
Huh. Like, hello? So, pretty much everything is going on in Derelict Row. Gotta do the side mission for Jenny and the main mission. Now, this is kind of tricky, because this is where the stealth aspect comes into play. Gotta be super careful in terms of the stealthy aspect of this.
Jensen, I'd appreciate it if you instructed your street informants to use more conventional means of contacting you.
Excuse me?
What are you talking about, Richard?
What are you talking about?
I mean, I found a message stapled to your door. Colo, alley off Bagley Avenue, Ezekiel. How cryptic.
That's near Seraph HQ. I'll look into it. Oh, and it's Cholo.
Cholo. Meet the mysterious informant. Voices from the dark. It's close to Seraph Industries, huh? There's Derelict Row. So there's the package. It's over here. So it's actually... So if I actually went over here, I could probably get it, but I don't know if I can go through there. Can I? So I head back over to Seraph. Ah, over here. This alley over here, huh? Okay. Well, you know what? Why don't we, actually, real quick, hold on. Let's see if I, wait, what direction was that? Hold on. Where am I on the map? Nope. This way. All right, can I actually go through this doorway over here? Oh, it's right here. That's the package, huh? Alright, so I found the package. Trying to see where it tells me that I'm supposed to, Oh, hold on a second. Retrieve the package. Bring it back to Jenny. Although she didn't want me to talk to her until after I've done everything. So, because it could be risky, she said. So, I guess when we come back, I might just head over to go see this informant before we go in there, you know, and see if we can take care of that. Stay tuned.